upset about me. Yeah, told him I would be a boss before I had business. I don't even need nobody here to vouch. I was all alone, so I ain't have a witness. Right back to the lab. Gotta go to work, I'm revving up my engine. I was just putting groceries in the bag. Now wait a minute, yeah, forgot to mention. I'm $100 million richer. Might paint $100 million picture. One man army, but I don't fatigue. Better have $100 million coming with you. Got good karma, so I'm riding fiscal. Hit the crossover, leave them playing Twister. Oh, they thought that I was just a... Now when I'm through, they call me mister. Stop it. Big wall will suffice. Play with the family, playing with your life. Just got the ops hurt, looking sick. So we gon' disinfect them like a wipe. Had that boy a big cat with no stripes. Now on the gram, ain't worried about a light. Yeah, I had to go ahead and raise the fee. If you ain't rocking with it, take a hike.
Say you gon' ride. Say you gon' step by me. Spin the slide. Say you gon' step by me. Who gon' step by me? Who gon' step by me? Say you gon' ride. Is he gon' step by me? Can't do it back, keep racks on me. Nah, hell with, I keep three on me. Oh, so you riding. I can do everything that you gon' like. Young, rich, and famous, I'm living the life. Oh, pull up in that new thing. I'm swerving and hogging the both lanes. You know I'm in the mood. After I score, I'ma bring it to you. They're a free agent, I give them the boo. I'm with the crew who we bringing it to. We got no limit, yeah, we on the ride. We all gon' step, we all gon' ride. Say you gon' ride. Say you gon' step by me. Spin the slide. Say you gon' step by me. Who gon' step by me? Who gon' step by me?
Every time I'ma step with the steppers. Black and white bins looking like pepper. Flawless diamonds, yeah, I'm good under pressure. 400 racks tucked in the dresser. Blowing money fast like Big Meech. Thinking that they winning, big reach. They know I'm the best, I'm elite. I know when they hating is instant.
Say you gon' ride. Say you gon' step by me.
Now for the so-called City Beautiful and home to the Madden Studios. This is EA Sports coverage of the National Football League from Orlando, Florida. Today, it's a Week 14 matchup that should be a good one, as it'll be the Dragons of Memphis and the Orlando Orbits. Two teams trying to stake their claim to postseason football. Week 14 of the NFL is underway. Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone, as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line. They started on the ground with Eckler. The heck of it. And now off to the races, down the right side. Austin Eckler, and down to the 29-yard line. 56 yards rushing for him here as he starts to draw closer to a 1,000-yard campaign.
Well, welcome to the party. First carry of the game. How about that?
And just think, as far as he's concerned, he's just getting warmed up.
First down, and they stick with Eckler. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two. But this defense, very strong in that victory from a week ago.
No matter what coverage was called, they were right in the hip pockets of the receivers all game long, step for step, running their routes with them. Turned out they were right there every time the ball was in the air, and they came away with 5 interceptions in that one.
On second down, Eckler. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
They did tell us they wanted to establish the ground game early, didn't they?
They did, and a small sample size that we've seen so far, but pretty good return.
Yeah, you got to like that. They've strung together a couple of first downs, established what they wanted, the running game. And guess what? They also got their lead guy running it pretty well, too.
Yeah, he hadn't gotten far enough away from the pocket to throw that football away, and that draws the flag.
Yeah, the old tackle box, right? Get outside of each tackle, and then you can go ahead and throw it away. You're in good shape, but if you're back there in the pocket, you got to make sure of what you're doing.
That'll be a gain of 16, and it'll be third down. They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. Hooker wants to change the look. On third down, here's Eckler. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down.
Tucker's kick is good. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx it.
Fair catch. Going to be taken, and this will be moved out to the 25. Three and a half to go, first quarter. First down, they start out with a ball to Camden.
And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Miles Garrett showing that athleticism as he gets in to make the play.
So a five-yard run the other way in the wrong direction, and that leads us to second and 15. Levis to throw off play action. He'll fire deep downfield for Lamb. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
But you look at this defense. Well, they played well against the pass, currently ranked seventh in the NFL.
And while teams don't like to talk about it, they're pretty proud of their rankings. But this ranking is going to be put to the test today because they're going up against a top five passing offense in this one.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He's going to go up top again. Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. Jalen Petrie picks it off. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
CD, what a sensational start for this defense. Instead of just forcing the three and out, which they were about to do, they pick it off and take it in for the score.
Yeah, I mean, they didn't just settle for the standard good way to start a game. They started in dramatic fashion. Take it away, score points, and guess what? They'll be flying to go back out there on defense again after that play.
Tucker with the extra point, and the lead grows to 10-0.
Justin Tucker set to kick off.
So an early 10-0 lead for them now as they kick it away. From his end zone, here's Rashid Shaheed. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. They'll look to get something started. They need to, down 10-0 early as they've got it first and 10. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stopped that one by the line of scrimmage.
That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
You can almost hear the sigh of relief coming from their sideline and from their point on the field because this has been a tough start for them thus far. A much-needed first down there. They needed something good to happen. Plays like that will continue to help them dig out of this hole.
First and 10, here's Levis. To the sideline, and that is a heck of a catch as he was able to get both feet in. So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive.
Levis to throw it.
Throwing the out route incomplete. That's Ferguson. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
I tell you what, it looks like he's shaking off that pick six just fine. It's not just defensive backs that have to have short memories. Quarterbacks utilize that as well. A much more confident throw right there.
And Levis going back to the air.
And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. Second down.
Not a great start dropping his first target, but let's face it, it won't be his last chance because he'll get opportunities to make up for that one throughout this game.
Levis throwing again on second down. And the out route gets Lamb to the ground.
And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
Those are the kinds of plays right there that show you why he's the number three man in the NFL in terms of receiving yards.
Also tells you there's a full combination of what he's got going in his game. You name it, from route running to catching the football, that's why he's able to produce those types of numbers.
Open man left side, Shaheed has it. He'll get only two there, and it's second and goal.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there, swarming to it?
And he'll get in. He's over for the touchdown. Will Levis scoring on the sneak from a yard out. And the Orbits have cut it back within a score. Extra point by Butker is on target. And that'll cut it to 3-10-7. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. But no run back here. Fair catch, and this will come out to the 25. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And the stakes in this game certainly high as we get toward the end of the regular season. For now, they are holding a wild card spot, but there are no shortage of other teams in the NFC looking to take that spot from them.
Starting with the guys on the other side of the field, because they're on the outside looking in, and no one likes to be in that position. You want to be in the room, not looking inside to see everyone else having fun.
This is a counter play, Eckler, and that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. 10-7 our score after one right here on EA Sports. They'll come up facing 3rd and 5. Hooker's going to throw it. Takes a shot on the release, as this would be incomplete.
My man, oh no, momentum might be changing jerseys right now. How about what they just got done? They scored a touchdown their last drive. Now here's a 3 and out. Maybe momentum's getting ready to creep to the other sideline.
On 4th down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. Fielded at about the 28. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. A nice punt, but a good run back as well, 13 yards. And out will come the offense as they take over. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive.
A long drive last time out for this offense, Charles. If you remember, they started basically in the shadows of their own end zone, marched it down the field, and a lot of that was through the passing game.
And partner's a former defensive back. I'm having almost a physical reaction watching what's happening right now. But let's give credit where it's due, because they've done an excellent job moving the ball through the air. Secondary getting picked apart pass by pass. Obviously, they need to make some adjustments there on the back end.
And because offensively, we know that they're not going to be shy about throwing that football.
Back to the air on 2nd down. Levis. Out of his hands quickly to CeeDee Lamb. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. Be taken in by Shaheed. So 5 yards here, 5 on the play, and that'll make it 2nd down.
Levis out of the shotgun now.
That's caught. This is a Abanikanda. 2 yards on the pickup there, and this will wind up being a 3rd and 3.
Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first.
He'll find Lamb. That's complete. So nothing doing there. And that'll bring bring up fourth down.
Excuse my snarkiness here, but isn't the idea of completing a pass supposed to mean you get downfield and gain yards?
Especially on third down.
Yeah, that one. How about the defense? Figured that one out in a big way. Yeah, they completed it all right and lost yardage.
And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. How about them biting off 15 yards there on the fourth down attempt and keeping the drive alive? Abana Canda on first and 10. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. This will be play number 9 of the drive here as they need 4 yards on third down. Back to throw, it's Levis. He's going to get that to his running back out of the backfield. And he takes it inside the 10 to the 8 before he's out of bounds. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. As Shaheed going to go in motion. The give now to Abana Canda. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. A good run of 6 yards there. Gets him closer to the goal line with second down coming up.
It's largely been the air attack that's gotten him down here, but now is where you start to lean on that running game. That's a good pickup there on first and goal.
From the 2 now, second and goal. Two minutes remaining in the first half. 10-7, our score. Second and goal, and they will try again from the 2-yard line. Levis. This is caught. Touchdown. Israel Abana Canda. His fourth touchdown on the year. And his guys have taken the lead. Extra point by Butker is on target. And the lead is now 14-10. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. As we eat closer and closer to intermission, Charles, remember last time out they punted. They would love to get points here, especially if this is going to be their final possession of the first half.
Yeah, and this is what close games feel like because the pressure is on both sides, but sometimes the pressure is a little bit higher on the team with the slight edge because they're trying to hold on to that, trying to increase it. Let's see how this one continues.
A run with Harris out of the shotgun. He'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. So that one will get him halfway to the first down marker. 7 yards, makes it 3rd and 7 now.
You've got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball because they were in a 2nd and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to 3rd and manageable with that run.
They'll run out of the gun with Eckler. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. As the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number 1. They'll break the huddle here and go for it. This is 4th down. They'll go for it. Hooker. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. Big strides. Look at him go. Touchdown! Taysom Hill, 73 yards. And the Dragons will take the lead here in the final minute of the first half. That certainly went against the traditional ways of playing football, but who cares? Look at the result. Big touchdown.
They went for it on their own side of the 50. So there's conservative, there's aggressive, and there's really aggressive, which is what we just saw there. Tip of the cap to them.
Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and it's now 17-14. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. With this slim deficit closing in on the end of the first half, we'll see if they can move this at least into field goal range and try to get three out of this drive. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Following the incomplete pass, here they go again, second and 10 from the 25. Now Levis. As he throws there, incomplete.
Well, they approach this drive with a lot of confidence after their last one ended up as a touchdown. But incompletions on their first two throws has them huddling up and trying to figure out a big play here on third down to get their momentum going again.
Levis on third down. That's complete. It's Devin Duvernay. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. They'll throw it again with Levis. And his throw here is incomplete.
So many times we talk about coverage, we're just talking about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
Escaping the pressure right. Now throw on the run, but that's going to be incomplete.
Ray certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
Here's Levis. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Ferguson. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs. Levis to throw once more. And that's going to be incomplete.
Nice progress down the field was halted by that incompletion. They could try for some safe yards here to get things moving again or keep throwing it and pushing it downfield to try and pick up bigger yardage.
Levis now off of play action. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Ferguson. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. This is a 49-yard attempt, right hash. Butker's kick here is good, and that will do it for this first half. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number three here. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive.
This offense ready for the first drive of the third quarter. Well, quarters number one and two entertaining. We saw some good offense points put up, Charles, and all tied on the scoreboard.
And it sets us up for what could be a really fun second half, because we've seen both sides score almost at will here in the first half.
And now, here in the second half, getting the ball first, you've got to think, hey, we can go out and really run our offense the way we did in the first half. But if I'm a defensive player, all I'm thinking is, can I make a play to really help out my team and break this streak of offense?
And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down. Levis back to throw. That is caught. Michael Pittman with it. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Now he dumps this off over the middle. And he'll be stopped at the 35, but not before he picks up 7 yards. So another on-target throw, and that last one, Charles, going to put him up over 5,000 yards passing out for the season, and that is not an insignificant number.
Indeed it is not, because this is not a big list, and most of the guys on it, Drew Brees, Peyton Manning, Tom Brady, Dan Marino, they either are or will be Hall of Famers.
That one nearly 30 yards, 29 officially.
Boy, how about the speed with which this offense can get down the field? It's taken them no time at all to get down here, and now they're set up with a first and goal.
Well, from the gun, here's Abana Campbell. And he gets him a little bit closer and takes it from the 6 inside the 5 to the 4.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score one touchdown, you're without a doubt. And so far today, he's got one, but was denied as he tried to get the second one.
Second down, here's Levis. And it's caught. Touchdown. CeeDee Lamb with another touchdown, number 24 on the year. And the Orbits have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive of the second half. Extra point by Butker is on target, and they will take a 7-point lead. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And this game was all square at halftime, but now they find themselves down 7 following the opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter.
And they need to take a good, relaxing, deep breath, don't you think? Because right now they might start to feel like they've got to play catch-up here and start matching them point for point, but it's still too early to get there. They can still run their offense. Plenty of time to get back in this game.
And now they're in the hurry-up. Eckler are going to get it again on second down. 94 yards for him on the ground now, as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
Running on first down, Eckler. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. After the loss, they'll come up second and 13. Once more, here's Eckler. And able to use his blockers to get this up over the 40. A sizable gain there, 9 yards as they get it back to a 3rd and 5. They'll need 5 on this play to move the sticks. A give, Eckler running to the right. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage, it'll be back at the 36. Boy, that's a 5-yard loss. 4th down now.
That was well played there defensively. 2 tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them 7 blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef,
that they could let a tackler through. But that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
This offense converted once on fourth down earlier. Now they're out there again to try once more. Now with just 1 second showing on the play clock, we're going to get a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Staying out there. They look prepared to go here on fourth and 10. Hooker going to try and throw for it. A hit as he throws, and this is going to be incomplete. A surprising move to go for it predictably, at least somewhat predictably. It doesn't pay off, and the ball will go over on downs on the short side of the field. The handoff, Abanacanda. He'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of six.
An opportunity to get a drive started here at the end of the third quarter. What you're trying to do is break the game down a little bit. Don't let your guys see too deep into the game, into the future, and say, oh, we got to get here. No, right here, right in front of them, melt the clock down, get to the fourth quarter, try and keep going.
And try to keep that lead.
Exactly.
He's going to rifle one deep left side. And it's caught. Touchdown. CeeDee Lamb with now his second touchdown of this third quarter. And the Orbits will add on to their lead here in the final minute of the third. Extra point by Butker is on target. And the lead now up to 14. The touchdown. Here's Butker on to kick it away. The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. Back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And really, Charles, not much of a surprise that they're losing. They just haven't been able to get much of anything going in the pass game. And as you well know, in today's NFL, if the passing game isn't working, usually not much else is working either.
Exactly right about that, partner. And I know that right now the easy answer would be, hey, let's run the football. But that might not be everything you need. So despite the fact that they've struggled throwing it, they've got to find some type of a play. Multiple plays that puts the ball in the air and allows for them to have some success.
So a little bit of a stiffer challenge now. First and 15 following the delay of game. Hooker. And he's going to be brought down here in the backfield. Carl Lawson in there to get him, and that is sack number six now for him on the year. Found his way into the backfield, and he simply would not be denied.
But they say that life's all about opportunities, and that holds true when you're playing defense as well. How about him seeing that chance, making the most of it, did a great job of wrapping him up and bringing him down.
Now that after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. Here's Hooker. And going deep for Hill. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
Going for the knockout blow right there. I think if I'm up two scores, I'd be worried about an interception. But playing this way is what got him this lead. So you may as well ride it out to the end.
Now a shot taken on third down, but and it's going to wind up incomplete.
And they're at the point of the ball game now where they've got to take some chances. They've got to put the ball in the air and just see what happens. But this defense knows that all too well.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And they hit him as he throws, as this one's going to go straight down to the turf. Incomplete. The fourth down pass play doesn't work out. And now possession will go over inside the 15-yard line. Levis to throw on first and 10 here. And did he get the feet down? Yes, touchdown. CeeDee Lamb, a 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Orbits are looking to make it two straight as they add on to this fourth quarter lead. Extra point by Butker is on target. And the lead now to three touchdowns at 21. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And from back there, a wise move. He'll just sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. They were coming off the extra week of rest, but this team started sluggish, and it really didn't get any better from there, and trailing big here in this fourth quarter. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Another pass attempt, another incompletion. You figure defensively, you're in the fourth quarter here. You've held the team under 100 yards passing. You've done your job.
Especially in today's NFL, which is truly a pass-first league.
And he's upended after a gain of two out to the 27. This offense so far on third down, a pretty woeful 0-for-5 thus far. This is third and 8. He shakes it off, buying time to his left. And it'll find the open man. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they reach the 50. 23 yards on the play. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10.
Option play, and they'll give to Eckler.
A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Well, that's pretty symptomatic about how things have gone here. That play was just shut down right from the start.
And not going to give them a lot of confidence to help turn things around.
Eckler going to get it again on second down.
And he's going to take this one down to about the 46-yard line.
99 yards rushing for him now, as he has been tremendous all day long. Third down, Hooker looks to throw it.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hip, but they'll say it's incomplete.
I'll tell you what, partner, after he ices down, he's going to be a nice long soak in a hot tub after this one. He's been under duress the entire game.
And once again, hit as he throws. Fortunate that one wound up incomplete. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. He's got his target. That's complete. And all the way in for the touchdown.
Romeo Doubs,
46 yards.
And the Dragons have got it back to a two-score game here in the fourth.
Tucker with the extra point. And the lead will be cut down to 14. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown.
He will return this from deep in the end zone.
And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. This game was really a tussle, seemed like just a moment ago, and now they've got the momentum. A couple of scores on their last pair of drives, and a two-score lead. I think here now you go conservative, right? Run the football, work the clock.
You know, I usually agree with you, but I'm going after them right here. I
really?
Put this bad boy away. I wouldn't be afraid to throw it. They've got all the confidence, all the momentum on their side. Go ahead and take your dagger shot.
And got his man complete. A big play there. 51 yards. change in field position. From inside the 10, here's first down on the other side of the field.
On the ground, it's Abanikanda.
And he'll get it down inside the 30 to the 29-yard line.
Brought down by Willie Gay. Second and five. Levis looking to throw. Open man left side, Shaheed has it.
And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. A good pickup there, 21 yards. So it's our home team here in possession of the football as we come back. They've got it first and goal in a game that appears to have already been decided.
Going for the knockout punch. He'll try and run.
And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. A nice pickup of 6 there to get him closer to the end zone, and it'll be second and goal. 6-yard pickup brings up second and goal at the 2-yard line. That one looks like he'll throw here. They'll roll him out right. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
This is certainly a team that has proven it likes to target its backs through the air, and defensively, they were aware of that and certainly were prepared on that throw.
Abanikanda.
Well, they hit him in the backfield, and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4.
Levis sets up the throw here.
And it's caught. Touchdown.
Jay Ferguson.
From 3 yards out.
And the Orbits are closing in on a 9th victory on the year as they extend their lead. Extra point by Butker is on target.
And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And from back there, a wise move. He'll just sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive.
Well, this game, it has had no shortage of offense. They've been able to put up a decent amount of points on this side, Charles. They just have not been able to keep pace with the other offense they're going against here.
Yeah, it's a good way of pointing things out, because now it's not a total loss, because as you said, they've scored some points, so there's some plays they can build on, moments where the game plan actually worked. But overall, though, they were just out personnel. They were going up against a team that's playing at an elite level.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down.
From the gun, it's Hooker.
And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
We've seen this quite a few times in this game. Offensive line unable to keep leverage, unable to keep people away, facing a lot of pressure. Fortunate just to get rid of it.
One of the reasons they're down is that inability, though, to stop the pressure. We saw another example of it there.
Now a 2nd and 10. Hooker's going to throw it.
And it's caught. Touchdown. Taysom Hill. 2 catches, 2 touchdowns here so far.
And the Dragons get a bit closer. CD, you know, anytime they get close to the red zone, he is such a threat, and there he is again already, his 2nd touchdown of the ball game.
And I know it's probably a little bit of a failing on my part, but you know, I watch a game through defensive eyes, and I don't understand what the coverage was doing there. When he headed out deep, they should have adjusted and flowed towards him. Instead, they left him out there and gave him a chance to make a big play. And, of course, he did exactly that. His size, speed, and versatility makes him a top target in any game.
On to the kicking team. Get it? Yes. The onside kick works like a charm. Well, that certainly makes things more interesting. You get the score, then you get the onside kick. A little uphill battle still, but a start.
It's not mission accomplished, but the plan is working. They are in a great spot right now, and the best part, they put the defense right back out on the field after having already scored.
Yeah, they've got the momentum here today.
And that is going to officially draw the curtain on this one as the last throw intercepted.
Peter Baker with a pick.
But Charles, a lot of happy faces heading into the tunnel as this one ends.